Welcome. I'm David Pommerenke. I'm professor at the Institute of Electronics, Graz University of Technology, and our research and teaching area is electronics and electromagnetic compatibility. And I want to make a little example here. The little example kind of tries to explain why circuit thinking is usually sufficient, but in many cases, or in some cases, we have to go back to electromagnetic fields to understand. Think about the following situation. We have a high voltage tower, another high voltage tower, and we have high voltage wiring connect. Let's say it's a three-phase system, but I just show one of them. Now, if we ask people, maybe students of electric engineering or people on the road, where is the energy? And they say, oh yeah, the wires carry the energy. This is wrong. And this is what this movie is about. So I need to remind everybody of some very basic things in electromagnetic theory about electric field, magnetic field, and Poynting vector. So if we have, for example, in a wave, an electric field like that, and a magnetic field, let's say like that, then the energy flow will be in this direction. Hopefully I got it right. And let's say the energy flow would make green, the energy flow would be in this direction. So the energy flow is a cross vector product of the magnetic field and the electric field. Now let's look at our high voltage line, yeah? So from a side view, we have maybe one high voltage line and another high voltage line and another high voltage line, and we have an electric field. As the electric field maybe goes like this. These are roughly the electric field lines. And we have a magnetic field around each line. We have a magnetic field here, a magnetic field here, and a magnetic field here. This is the cross-sectional view. Now let's look at the side view. Here's the side view, and I just show one of the three wires. Yeah? So the electric field will go out from here. And the magnetic field will circle around here. The magnetic field. So what happens in the wire? Yeah, in the wire itself, in the cross section of the wire, there is no electric field, or nearly no electric field in the cross section of the wire. So the electric field which I draw now is wrong. If I say there's an electric field like inside, there's no electric field. There is a magnetic field inside, but not an electric field. So if there's no electric field, only a magnetic field, energy is not transported in the wire. So the energy transport is outside the wire. The energy transport is only where there's an electric and magnetic field. So the wire is not transporting the energy, but the wire is telling the electromagnetic field where to go. So it's a guided wave. The wires guide the electromagnetic energy, and the energy is outside the wire. Now it's even worse. What happens if energy enters the wire? So now we have the case that we have current flowing here. We have the Poynting vector here, and here we mounted a resistor. Now what happens to the Poynting vector? In this region, the electric field is still here. But in this region, the electric field will bend until we have this electric field along the wire. And the consequence is that the Poynting vector will bend because the magnetic fields, the magnetic field direction is not affected by the change. So there's a magnetic field here, we have a magnetic field here, we have a magnetic field here. So that bends the Poynting vector into the resistor. So the resistor will get hot. And here, this is the field illustration. Normally in a circuit, we wouldn't think about these electromagnetic fields. We would always think of Ohm's law, etc., etc. But there are situations where that description via Kirchhoff's law is insufficient. Then we have to go back to fields. And this example is to show that the energy is not transported in the wires. The wire guides the energy.